Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Wasteland 3. We're continuing on with our mission here against Vic Buchanan and his horrible, horrible consorts and friends and demonic bastards.
I'm hearing something to the left.
Yeah, so this is where Ash is. And let's go and interact with him. As you approach the sturdy security door, you're greeted by an unknown voice. Why not?
Well, this is where all the security systems are. I guess I shouldn't have told you that either. But what the heck? When I said you can't come in, I meant that I got a kill switch in here. Yeah, if you barge in, I gotta kill all the hostages.
Mm.
I'm, sorry about that, but that's what Vic told me to do.
You don't have to do that. Do this.
Stuck in a bad situation, and the only way out is to keep doing the stuff you don't wanna? This is one of those things. Okay! See you! Off button. There it is.
Okay, so we are not gonna call his bluff. So, it's good not to even go there. So let's go ahead and continue up here. There's going to be some roaming robots here?
Who sent you? Daddy? Or Libby? You can tell me. Don't be shy.
Alright, there's two of them out of the way. I think there are two more. There's like a gas hopper around the other side.
What a lovely old portrait.
That's some nice loot. Let's take this portrait. The picture shows a mother in a yellow dress with her three daughters. Three daughters, yeah. You found a picture of a middle-aged woman with three young girls, possibly her daughters. The picture does not look old enough to be pre-war, but it is covered in a layer of dust, as if no one has looked at it in years. Alright, there should be a wandering hopper around here somewhere. I'm just gonna send Sweet Tea up, perhaps, to take care of it. Let's see it this way. It's like, oh, now you won't come, right? Oh, there he is. Takes him out. There should be another one. Let's get the group up. She has sneaky shit, and if we accidentally wander into this guy's path, then she can back off pretty quickly, fairly quickly. There he is, right there. Alright, let's try this again. Oh, Spazeppi is helping. I see. Oh no! Well, that's not what I wanted to do, but okay, that's fine. There we go. So Pazeppi is in here, and she... Well, we'll get to her soon, but we did have some friendlies helping us out there. It was a little blunder on my part, but we still got through it. Alright, our next call to action is fight a little battle in here. I'm sorry, it's not in here. It's in the next room. But we'll go in here anyways.
Jesus.
Aspen is under attack. The label is peeled away from this old and battered cassette tape. In its place are a string of bloody thumbprints and it's set in a neat line.
Everyone calm down. This childish hysteria is beneath you. You're members of the 100 families, for God's sake. Act like it.
Spring Quan on in here.
Nothing more. I don't know how they managed to get up here, but there's no chance they'll make it inside. We're protected by the best guards money can buy. Don't worry. That was one of ours. Bandits don't carry rocket launchers.
Oh yeah, sure.
Nobody panic. The guards must have shut off the power as a safety precaution. Everything is going to be fine.
Oh dear. That was pretty intense. I like that. Let's go ahead and talk to Llewellyn here. The bloodstained young man appears to have been stabbed. He looks up at you and has a joyous realization.
You're the Rangers. I knew you'd be coming to save us. I never gave up hope.
You've heard of us?
Sure. When the Patriarch said you were coming, I bought the history of the Desert Rangers off a trader. I read it cover to cover that very night. And the moment we got attacked here, I knew you'd be coming to our aid. As you can see, Rangers, I've been stabbed, just like the others. But I held on. Played dead, and when none of them were looking, I swallowed the key, Rangers.
Good job.
No thanks needed, Rangers. Keeper of the Treasury. That's my job, and I take it very seriously. The treasure of the 100 families is safe as long as Llewellyn is around.
He wobbles, then catches himself.
Maybe this is too much to ask, but do any of you happen to be a doctor? I'm not feeling so good.
Unfortunately, we don't have that. You work here?
Yes, Rangers. I'm part of the staff. Dozens of us work up here. Kept the place nice for the families. Vic killed the staff first. He was brutal, but quick. Didn't think we'd be as much fun to torture, maybe.
We want that key you ate.
Oh, I see. You want to make sure everything's secure. Not to worry, Rangers. It's right here, in my belly. Nobody's getting their hands on it. It's good and stuck in there. Mark my words.
Guess he's never seen any movie from the Saw series, huh? Alright, is there any other way into the treasury?
Nope. The door only has one key, and I ate it. And if someone wants it, why they had to cut it out of me.
Okay, so we're not gonna do that. On my evil playthrough, though, this will happen. So, stay here for now.
Right, I'll lay low.
All right. There is an alternate way. I think with first aid, you can utilize a chemical station and use a laxative and give it to Llewellyn. We may try that, even though we haven't officially discovered that, and we don't have first aid. All right, there are some enemies in here, so we'll go ahead and get prepped up to take these guys out. Oh, I'm getting discovered. Let's just go ahead and get everyone positioned up here. Forgot she had that on, but damn, it messed him up pretty bad, didn't it? Alright. Just hell. Just a little bit farther forward, please. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Bring her back. Sweet tea. Let's go ahead and have you step out, please. Lucia. It's a gashopper here. Switch on over. Well, maybe we can just use the... Right, we'll see. Nice little luck action there. Let's switch on over, actually. Out of range. Stupid out of range. Even get a CPU attack. 20% chance to cause it to go to berserk. That'd be great. Nope, not enough. I'm just going to take it 3 more shots. Let's go ahead and get another shot in. Hopefully they blow up this flame tank. Nope, that's okay. Nice, you got a little, another little luck action. And another one. Target is blocked. Well, that's a shame. Guess we'll have to shoot this guy. Alright. Way back. Quan. The amazing Quan. Bloody out of range. Always, everyone's bloody out of range. Takes him out. We'll pull you back, Quan. Orgrim, come in and stand right there.
Moving to cover.
Go get him, buddy. Break that armor. Nice. Damage his armor. What's his armor looking like? I want to see that armor. Shot in the face, please. Shot again. And how about one more shot in the face? Good job, Lucia. All right, we just got this little guy back here. Perhaps Sweet Tea can... take it out. Well, we'll leave this to a corpse. He can do that extra damage. There you go. Go and give that a little quick save there, and let's loot it up. Guest suites, keys 1 and 2. Medical crate. And ammo box. Alright, let's give that a quick save. Let's see, I think someone, yeah, it looks like Sweet Tea went ahead and leveled up. Still pumping up her coordination here. I wonder if they have those extra action points. And then nerd stuff. Still can't get maxed out on nerd stuff. There's actually a book for nerd stuff. I need to find where it is. But she can't spend any points at the moment. She has a point that she can spend here in the perks. And I guess we'll just pop this into overclock. Hacked robots gain plus 2 AP. Anyone else? Nope. Quick save that. And we'll go into this door first.
Okay, Pris. You can do this. There's no point in both of us dying. Just close your eyes and run.
I can't do it, Violet. I really can't do that to my sister.
You have to, Pris. Do it. No, wait. Who is that? You. You're not with them. Help us, please. Vic Buchanan forced us to stand on pressure plates. If one of us steps off, it'll blow up the other. One of us has to make a run for it and kill the other. Eventually, we'll be too tired to stand and we'll both die. We can't even take a step. I think maybe the trap can be disabled with that box over on the wall there, but we can't reach it.
Ladies, it's me, Lucia, remember? We'll find a way to get you out of there, I promise.
Lucy? But you look so...
Cool. Look at her, Violet. She's got scars now. She's a proper Wasteland warrior.
She flushes, then nods at you. Let's see. We're gonna look around and see what we can do to help you.
Take a look at the electrical box. There must be something you can do there. Please hurry.
Okay. Let's go and have... I think we can have, Corpse go over here and finagle this thing. The cables running across the floor terminate in a metal box bolted to the wall. The front panel looks like it can be detached easily. Remove the panel. The panel comes off easily, revealing a nightmarish tangle of wires. Whoever put this device together was either in a hurry or had very little idea of what they were doing. Mechanics 8, there we go. Look for a way to disable the power. The mess of wires is impossible to entangle, but the shoddy workmanship also means the device is easy to short-circuit. Using several bits of metal and your engineering know-how, you interrupt the flow of electricity.
That was amazing! You just reached in there and fixed stuff!
Why didn't we just pull the wires coming from the box?
Priscilla blinks, then smacks her forehead.
Wouldn't be that easy, ladies. Stuff like that only works in stories.
Oh, and, Lucia, I'm sorry about Isaac. He's an idiot.
I know.
Where are you headed now?
Away, I suppose. We'll run back to Colorado Springs, if we have to. Our mother is here, too. She's in the Patriarch's wing with Victory. She's not pleasant, and she doesn't much care for us, but if you can... Please help her.
She nods to herself, gives you a final smile, and leaves. All right. Let's check some loot in here. Marriage counseling. The casing of this ancient cassette tape is cracked in places, but still seems functional. The typewritten label is badly faded, and the writing lost under layers of grime.
Session 13, Jim and Nancy, March 21st, 1998. Nancy, last time you were talking about Jim's inadequacies as a sexual partner. Would you like to expand on that?
Now wait just a goddamned minute. You've let her talk for 12 sessions straight. When's my chance?
See, Dr. Meltzer, this is what I'm talking about. Everything's always about him.
Why the hell am I paying for these sessions when you're always taking her side?
If you're unhappy with counseling...
Unhappy? I wish the fucking bombs would fall, so I wouldn't have to deal with another minute of this.
What's that noise?
Uh-oh.
I don't know. Maybe some kind of drill?
Oh, no, is that... It can't be.
Oh, thank God.
He's like, oh, thank God. That is great. That was so funny. Alright, let's go and loot this real quick. Okay, we all get this melee damage bonus, but obviously it only helps one of us. And we get a heart stopper. So. Let's go pick this lock. This man has been badly beaten. From the nearby tripod and hook, you can deduce they've been using him as a human punching bag. He should be given medical aid before moving him to avoid further injury. And we do just happen to have first aid one because of Corpse's little utility trinket he's got on him right now equipped. You definitely treat his wounds. Mere moments after you stabilize him, he takes a deep breath, rasping breath. Takes a deep rasping breath and notices you for the first time. Peering through swollen eyes, he takes in your ranger uniforms and chuckles. His amusement is interrupted by a coughing fit.
Fuck. Oh. Rangers, huh? You made it.
You're going to be okay.
Oh, sure I will. gotten tenderized before. Doesn't mean I gotta enjoy it. This shit's my fault, not yours. Couldn't keep my mouth shut. Never could stand bullies, and this place is fucking full of them. Anyway, you came for me, and I won't forget that. I guess you took out the guards. Bastards ain't so tough now.
Where's Victor Buchanan?
Patriarch's wing. They dragged me in there a bunch of times for my hourly beatings. I didn't mind much. It's better scenery. Gonna be hard for you to get inside. Heavy security door. Also, I'm pretty sure they're holding the leader of one of those ruling families in there, so take it slow and check your targets.
Yep. All right, check his wounds.
Hands off. I'm fine.
When you're ready, head for the lobby.
I will. Just gotta rest a little more.
All right. See if we can do one more thing here before we're in the episode, and we'll pick this lock here. Hopefully, nothing explodes in our faces. Ooh, display case. It's a little loot room. Gold-plated hammer, a smaller gold-plated cast of the Patriarch's signature weapon. This early prototype is too light to be wielded as a real weapon. The design of the handle makes it seem like it was meant to slide into a specific groove. $2,000 we can sell that for. Very nice. I can dig that. What else we got in here? Got some commando leg armor. It's got a nice little combat speed addition there. Deathlance, another Deathlance. Crazy. That's what we're using, right? Deathlance? Yeah, we're using Deathlance. Just wanted to double check that. Okay. Not bad. And a silver dollar necklace. This is another barter plus one. We don't need that, though. And let's go ahead and loot these little bags up here. And I think we need to loot back here. I just want to double check. Yeah, there's some loot bags here we didn't loot. The previous ones. There we go. All right, we're going to head over this way. And we're going to head in and talk to the gift, but that'll be in the next episode. Thank you guys for joining me on this one. We are slowly, ploddingly, but we're getting through this mission. And yeah, it's been pretty fun so far. And if you've enjoyed this up to this point, please consider hitting that like button. I'll talk to you later. Thanks, guys. Bye.